What's up, ghouls? It's Blaze and welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you a super fun video where I show you how to recreate this over the top glittery look, and I review Geordie or It's Likely Makeup's brush collab with Furless Brushes. So I've wanted to try Furless Brushes for the longest time. I never really knew which ones to get, and because they're either like Australian or American, depending on which site you order from, I knew the shipping was going to be really costly, so I just kept putting it off. And then Geordie announced that she was doing a collab, and I was like, this is my time to get some brushes, support a great YouTuber, and try out a new brand. So I did just that. So we are reviewing the set. I think I used 10 out of the 20 brushes today, which was pretty good. Yeah. So if you want to watch how, or if you want to see how to get this crazy, glittery, shimmery, I don't even know look, and if you want to hear, I cannot talk, if you want to hear my verdict on the brushes, then keep watching. Okay, so let's just get right into it. So this is the box here. I put everything back in the original packaging just so I can show you guys how cute it is. So this is the box that I got in the post. Like, this was in like a crappy cardboard box, but this is the first thing we've seen. The pumpkin's gonna be noisy today. So then as you open it up, you see this big package here. There's a lot of opening packages. This is just so cute. If you have like a closer look at it, and the one around here, it says It's Likely Makeup, and then it's got the little logo thing in the center. It says vegan and cruelty free, professional brush apron included, 20 professional makeup brushes, faux fur technology, brought to you by It's Likely Makeup. So then, once you open that, have a card from Geordie. It says, hi guys, Geordie here. Let me share some of my favourite brushes from this set, as well as some of my makeup tips. So she says her three favourite brushes at the bottom there. You can see that. And then on the back gives you a breakdown of what every single brush could be used for. So cute. Okay, so then once you open it up, you've got this tissue paper, and it's the same print as the initial box. It's Likely Makeup. That, then you get the brush belt here, so it says Furless and It's Likely Makeup, so it says really cool rose gold colour. And then once you pop it open, again Furless and It's Likely Makeup, you're never gonna be able to see that because it's so shiny. And then when you open it up, all the brushes are inside. So many brushes! So I'm so excited to use these. So I'm just gonna go straight into it because I am slightly pushed for time. It took ages for my brushes to get here, which was really shit because I was so excited waiting for them. I can't remember exactly, I want to say like just over 2 weeks, which to be fair isn't too bad from America, but I just wish that they were UK based so that I didn't have to wait for so long. I did get hit by customs charges. If you follow me on Snapchat, which you should, then you would have seen that. I think it was £32 something, which is just like beyond ridiculous. And Royal Mail have added a handling fee for customs, so you have like your initial customs charge and then £8 for their international handling fee, which is just so dumb. Like, that really annoys me. Why do they need a handling fee? So yeah, it's expensive ordering Furless brushes. I think the actual shipping from the store was only $20, so it's going to be less in UK pounds, probably about £15-16, which isn't too bad considering they're coming all the way from America, but the customs was really, really shit. I've just used the Kat Von D Locket Hydrating Primer and the Urban Decay Optical Illusions Primer for my base. Also, apologies about my voice, I think I'm getting ill. She says the Pro 4F is about to become your favourite foundation brush in the whole world. Throw some foundation on your skin first, then buff it in using circular motions for a flawless finish. So I'm going to do my foundation and use the 4F. Yes. So this is what it looks like. All her brushes are like this rose gold and this soft pinky colour with It's Likely Makeup written on there, if you can see that. So the Pro 4F is like a big, it's like a stippling brush, it's quite dense, and it's got this kind of like, I would not know how to describe this. This is what it looks like. I'm really, really excited to give it a go, because usually I would use a beauty blender for my foundation, so I'm really excited to try this out. I'm also going to be using, for the first time, my Kat Von D mirror, which you can see here, and it's got the little stars on it. I ordered this from the Kat Von D store, the Kat Von D American website, and I didn't have to pay customs for this package, unbelievably. I think the mirror was $18, maybe a bit less, I can't remember. It wasn't too pricey, I was quite impressed actually, but I've been wanting it for ages and I thought they had a sale on in the store, I think 20% off. So I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna go ahead and order some bits and pieces, but only stuff that I definitely can't get in the UK. So I'll talk about that a bit later. So let's buff this in. Kat Von D foundation is very dry, so I think using a dampened beauty blender is really good because it gives that bit of added moisture. Whereas this kind of drags it around a little bit, but it is giving quite a nice finish. And it's definitely blending it out well. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop a little bit more foundation on because I need a bit more coverage. Okay, so I definitely don't love it with this foundation. I think it is just too drying for it to be really, really good. But I feel like with a quite a liquidy foundation like the NYX Total Control Drops, something like this would be so good for that. Planning on getting that foundation to give it a go, but they don't seem to sell it in any NYX store that I visit, so that's really annoying. So I will try that out at a later date. Right, next I'm going to pop on some concealer using my Kat Von D White Out Concealer. Let's see if she recommends any brushes. Pro 1M Apply and Blend Concealer under the eye area, around the nose and on the face. Okay, so Pro 1M is literally the first brush I've picked up. Okay, so this is a quite a small tapered brush. I've never used anything like this for concealer before, so this should be fun. Again, it's quite dense, but it's still got enough of like a, it's still movable. So let's keep it going. Again, I think the formula of that concealer is very drying and my skin's quite dry, so it seemed that dragging it around with a brush wasn't necessarily the best thing for my skin. I think I would definitely in the future for this foundation and concealer routine use my beauty blender for the bits I've done so far, but there's more to come, so let's keep going. Right, so next I'm going to set everything with my powder, and I bought RCMA No Colour Powder, so I'm really excited to try this. I think this was about £13 from Beauty Bay, and you get 3 ounces, so you get a lot of product in there. Pro 3F is for powder. I don't know what to use to pack the powder on under my eyes. I think I'm gonna use the Pro 2F to pack the powder on under my eyes, and then the Pro 3F for powder for the rest of the face. So this is a comparison. It's just like a little smaller version. I also feel that this maybe could be good for highlight, but we'll see. So again, typically I would use a beauty blender for this step because I feel like it really locks the powder in there. These brushes are so soft. This is so, it's like relaxing. Powder evenly across your face, does give it a nice finish. Also, I'm quite impressed. None of these brushes have shed. Usually when you use brush for the first time, it tends to shed a little bit, but I haven't had that at all, so I'm really happy about that. You can definitely tell they're high quality. So next up is contour. I've got powder everywhere, and I use a powder contour, so you need to find a brush to use. For my contour, I'm going to be using the shade Lazarus from the Shade and Light palette, which is this big pan here. Okay, so she recommends the Pro 5F for contouring. So it is an angled brush and it's quite fluffy, which means that you're going to be able to get a nice blend. So let's try this. Usually I use quite a dense brush when I contour, so it's quite odd actually using this brush set because I've changed up my usual routine a lot, which makes me think, have I been doing it wrong this whole time? I think the angle of the brush seems to be really good for being able to get right into the hollows of your cheekbones, so I do really like that. Yeah, it seems to be quite nice. I quite like that brush for contour, and again, it's just so freaking soft. Okay, so for my eyebrows, I'm not going to be using a brush. I'm going to be using the NYX Precision Brow Pencil. So I'm going to throw my brows on and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've done my brows and I popped down a base of the White Out Concealer on my eyelids as a primer, and then set that using my RCMA No Colour Powder. So we're going to start with the eyes, and I'm going to be using the Pastel Goth palette today. I haven't actually used this yet. I've had it for probably like 3 or 4 months and it's just been sitting there and I need to use it. So I'm gonna be using it today. This is what it looks like for those of you that haven't seen it. If you haven't seen it, where have you been? So I'm really, really excited to use this today. So I wanna do like a really pinky, purpley, holographic-y, silvery look. That's kind of my plan. So I'm probably gonna be using the shades Meow, Dope, and Doom, which are these three along here. So I'm really excited to play with those. And then I'm also gonna be combining that with the Alchemist palette as well. So let's get into that. So I'm really excited to use these eye brushes. I'm so excited. Okay, so these are like the big like 4 eye brushes. So this is what they look like. So we have the Pro 2E, the Pro 8E, Pro 7E, and Pro 4E. And Geordie recommends the Pro 3M for smoking out the bottom lash line and blending shadows. Let me grab that too. And that is this little pencil brush type dude. So we're going to be using all of these brushes here. Okay, I'm going to start with 2E, I think, and I'm going to take the shade Meow, which is the like a pinky purple, and I'm just going to start blending that on my inner and outer corner. Swap over to the Pro 4E and I'm going to carry on with that same Meow shade and just really load that colour up. because this is a denser brush, it's allowing me to pack on the colour a lot easier. Okay, so going back in with the 4E, I'm going to take the shade Dope and pack this on to the centre of my lid. Okay, to add some definition, I'm going in with the Pro 3M and I'm going back in with Meow and just touching up the inner and outer corners. Pro 7E, and I'm going to blend the shade Meow through the crease again. Okay, I'm using the Pro 7E again and I'm taking that onto the lower lash line. Going back in with this Pro 3M, the really tiny little pencil brush, and just adding some definition to the lower lash line with Meow, making sure it's really, really pigmented. Okay, using that same brush, I'm going to take a little bit of Doom, the tiniest bit, and I'm going to pop that in the outer corner. I'm going to swap over to the Alchemist palette and I'm going to be using the shade Ultraviolet Amethyst, and I'm going to be popping that all over where I put the shade Dope, so it's going to be all over my lid. And I'm just using my finger for that because I think it gives the best look. And then I'm going to be using the shade Pink Opal on my inner corner. I'm going to pop a little bit of that Pink Opal on the outer corner too. Some added shimmer, Next up, I'm going to be taking a glitter eyeliner from the shade, from the brand Collection, and the shade is number 4 Hustle, and I'm going to be doing a normal winged eyeliner look but just with glitter instead. Okay, so I'm going to go in with some mascara and I'm using the Too Faced Better Than Sex. True Geordie fashion, I'm going to be adding some freckles, but to match this look I'm going to be popping some freckles on with little star, are they just craft stars? So just silver craft stars like this, and I'm going to try and use my Glitter Fix gel from Pink Glow to adhere them, and I hope that works because I've lost my eyelash glue. These are super, super cute, but I've just realised I was too excited about the stars and I forgot to put my highlight on. So I'm going to check what brush I should use. 2F. Ooh, okay, I used that one for powder. So I'm just going to try and place the highlight over the stars and hope that works. So I'm going to be using the shade Pink Opal from the Alchemist palette, and I'm going to be pressing it on real light. Okay, it kind of worked. I'm just going to go over the top of that with a little bit of Ultraviolet Amethyst. We have a bit of glow happening, not a lot. Maybe I need to structure these videos better. Okay, I'm gonna go in with the final product for this look, which is the lips, and I'm so excited. So this is the limited edition Everlasting Glimmer Veil in the shade Starflyer. So this isn't available on the UK website. This is a US only, which is why this is like the main reason I ordered from the American site in the first place. So I managed to get this mirror, this glimmer veil, and the Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in the shade Plan 9, which is the green, which again isn't available in the UK. I am so excited to have these products. It's just like, ah! So I'm going to go ahead and apply 2 layers of Starflyer to make sure it's super, super pigmented.
No.
Okay, so I've just popped a Starflyer on. I'm officially in love. I kind of wish I'd bought two because I never wanted this to run out. This is like the prettiest glimmer veil I've ever seen in my life. But when I first started the look, I wasn't really feeling it. My base, I'm really not happy with due to my skin just being so dry that buffing those products in with a brush probably did more harm than good, to be honest. And then as I started using the Pastel Goth palette, I was like, oh my god, this look is just failing. Like, I've always found this palette a little tricky to use. I've used it once before. I don't think I filmed it on camera. I was just experimenting with it. And I found that the shadows didn't really show up very well. When you swatch them, they do look so pretty, but then when I found when they translate to my eyes, they just weren't as popping as I wanted them to be. And then I had a similar issue today when I started using it and I was thinking, oh my goodness. But I think the glitter liner definitely saved the eyes. I mean, they're still not perfect, but they're a lot better than they were. And the Alchemist palette saves the day, saves my life, saves everything. The glitter freckles or the star freckles are cute as fuck. I feel like a little Valfrey girl. And then the glimmer veil just wins at life, basically. So my verdict on the brushes, I really, really like the eye brushes. I'm really, really happy with those. I think there's a good range in the set as well. You've got like the angled brush, or you've got like the big fluffy blending brush. You've got the little precision brush. There's 2, 4, 6, 8. There's 10 brushes still in here that I haven't touched. One of those being this. Ooh. Giant fan brush, which probably would have been quite cool for highlight had I remembered to put my highlight on. And then we've got like a little angled brush, which would have been really, really good for doing brows, if you do like pomade or something, but I didn't do that today. There's another big face brush, which I think I'll try next time. So this is the Pro 6F. It's like a dual fiber, so I think that would be quite good for foundation. Again, with a more liquidy foundation. And then there's a couple like lip brushes and stuff like that. There's a couple brushes in there that look really good for doing like a cut crease as well. So there's definitely a lot of options with this brush kit. I think while it is on the pricey side, you're definitely paying for quality. None of these have shed. They all perform well. So I'm really, really happy with this brush set, and just the fact that they look good is a bonus. And of course, by buying the brushes, I'm helping out a fellow YouTuber by supporting her career, and I am 100% happy to support Geordie. So, that is it for this video. Should probably take these cat ears off now. Let me know what you thought of this look down below. I have a doctor's appointment to attend. Should I wear this look? Probably not. Do I want to? Yes. Yeah. Let me know what you thought down below, and if you have any more suggestions for further videos, then please pop those in the comments section too. Also, we are at 11,000 subscribers. 11,000, like, I can't even comprehend that. That is just beyond. I don't know what's happened here. I don't know why you guys are here, but thank you for being here. Don't forget to check out my younger sister's channel. She's just started and she is hoping to grow her channel, so her link will be in the description. Definitely check her out. You guys love my videos with her, so you'll definitely love her channel. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.